better AI models thanks to a little bit of image editing. Friends, I've got a trick, so let's get cracking. All right, so real quickly, this is a Detroit Lions Kool-Aid man. If I do Control H and hide that, there was a picture up here, but the AI did not come through real well. So friends, I'm gonna get a better picture. Let me show you how to do it. Of course, I started with a search, Kool-Aid picture, no face. They all had faces, so I ended up just grabbing a screenshot of this one right here. Of course, I capture with Snagit. I'm gonna quickly save it to my Dropbox as a PNG. Now we bounce to the program Pixlr-x. Love this tool. It is free, but we are stuck with ads. And after just a moment, if you zoom in, we can see the face, but we've also got the crisp edges. Here's how we're going to get rid of the face. Go to the heel tool. We want to use clone stamp. I'm going to make the source a little bit smaller, leave the softness, and then I'm going to set my source to the spot I want to fix. So I want to go right here, and I'm just going to go tap, tap, and boom, eyebrow gone. Match the lighting. Let's go over here. Source, tap, 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 tap. Eyebrow gone. Source. And of course, repeat this technique all the way around our shape. This makes it so much easier for the AI because those parts that we don't want, they don't exist when we send it. Once again, source, and this is going to take a couple clicks because it starts to get darker. And bingo, I'm going to call that done. Just for kicks, I'm going to go to adjust, and I'm going to add pop, just because that makes the edges stand out a little bit more. Note, if your design was already a size that you'd like, you'd simply hit save. I'm going to test it as a JPEG real quick, just to see if the size did matter. I'll just call it K-pitch and hit save. Notice I do only get 3 free saves per day. Now you can see I have opened Bambu Studio. I'm gonna switch to Maker Lab. Notice you can just visit the website as well. We're gonna scroll down to experiments and we're gonna try image to 3D model. I'm gonna click and open the picture. I'm gonna start with that tiny one called K-pitch and let's generate our 3D model. If you're looking down below, you'll notice that one generation failed. That was one I tried the other day. I'm not sure what caused that failure, but I simply retried and the next time it worked. These have been taking about 2 minutes per model, and I'm gonna speed up this wait using video editing real quick. And bingo, after just a little more than 2 minutes, we have got a working picture. How cool is that? Of course, you can switch between mesh or textured mode, and if you're happy, which I am, you can choose export. This wait was about 30 seconds. Note it does take a moment, and it does cost me a couple of credits. Someday it's going to cost 10. Right now it's only 2, which is absolutely worth it. So I'm going to hit confirm. Of course, in this video, I'll make sure that I have the link. And right now, I'm going to download it. I'm going to put it in my Lions folder where the Kool-Aid man is, and then I'm going to call this picture and hit save. All right, so I've quickly returned to the Kool-Aid man. Let's hide the infinity gauntlet. Let's choose import, choose file. Let's find that picture and let's bring it in. Uh-oh, file's too large. Let me show you quickly how to fix that. Friends, using any slicer based on Prusa, you can simply add the object. Of course, there is my picture. I'm going to accept all the colors. I don't really care. I do not like seeing this here though, so I'm going to hit others and disable the prime tower. And now I'm going to right click and simplify the model. Now it had 500,000 triangles, which is way too many. This is going to take it down to 8,000. I found the other day that even at extra high, it's going to be under the 200,000, which is the limit for Tinkercad. So I'm just going to hit apply. Model still looks fine, and now I can simply hit file, export, and I want export as one STL. I'm going to call it picture STL and save it to that exact same folder. Now we can return to Tinkercad. I'm going to close that. Once again, choose import, choose file. This time instead of picture OBJ, it's picture STL. I'm going to keep the measurements and choose import. Note it does take a moment, especially since I kept it as large as I could. But after a moment, bang, our picture has arrived. Now I want to get this to the right size. I'm going to just move it a little bit and I'm going to do shift scale to make it smaller. Just finding the numbers I think are cool. Now I'm going to rotate it to the angle that I want. Let's do control up arrow or control shift up arrow to get it close to where we think it should be. Find our angles that work the best for us. And just like that. And of course, pick a color that you think is fantastic. There is my little lion's Kool-Aid man and a picture. Of course, extra fun if we add a logo. Of course, friends, I want to add a logo to the picture. You can see I brought it in and I'm going to use an inverse hole technique. I've got several videos that show this technique. Right now, I'm just going to leave this one set to copy and tinker so you can ungroup it and explore how I did it at your leisure. This is what it looks like when the hole is cutting the logo. And bingo, you can see now it's got that rounded surface that we'd want for our picture. So there you have it, friends. Simple steps to edit an image so you get better results using AI. Now, as you can see, I modified this so it's got the Lions logo. That is called using an inverse hole. If you check up in the cards, I will have videos that show that off as well. Of course, friends, I do want to thank my supporters on Patreon. Love how that group is going. You can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. And finally, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.